The Philippine Children's Medical Center is making a master list of patients who are qualified and willing to be jabbed. They need to be 12 to 17 years old and have a medical certificate for a comorbidity that falls within the 11 illnesses listed by the Department of Health. The patient and parent or guardian must also consent to the vaccination.
We've got around 22, but that number is expected to balloon, okay, because now the people here, they are trying their best to be able to explain the benefits of giving the vaccine, okay, to the patients. And mukha namang maganda ang reception.
In Fed El Mundo Medical Center, around 250 patients have so far registered for vaccination. It targets to vaccinate an initial 60 children on Friday.
Nag-create muna kami ng Google link, no, para ma-identify namin yung mga possible na vaccine recipients. Ang priority talaga would be yung patients namin dito and yung mga dependents din na may comorbidity.
The National Children's Hospital is scheduled to hold a simulation for the COVID vaccination of minors on Wednesday. These hospitals assure patients and parents they are ready to respond should vaccine recipients report side effects.
Yung difficulty of breathing, no, and then yung anaphylaxis din. That's why may naka-ready naman kami dong emergency cart, no, tapos may stretcher din, tapos may mga gamot din kami for the mga yung allergies kung mahirapang huminga, and then kung halimbawa kinakailangan talaga silang dalhin kaagad sa ER, madadala naman namin sila sa ER.
Apart from PCMC, Fed El Mundo, and National Children's Hospital, five other hospitals in Metro Manila were designated as pilot jabbing sites for minors. The National Vaccination Operations Center says each hospital will receive an initial 1,170 COVID vaccine doses, but supply will be augmented as needed. So far, only Pfizer and Moderna's COVID jabs have emergency use authorization for children 12 to 17 years old in the Philippines. Of the over 87.6 million COVID vaccine doses that arrived in the country, around 21 million are manufactured by Pfizer, while 9.9 million are Moderna. The private sector, which procured Moderna doses, is also eyeing to vaccinate their employees' children. President Duterte, meanwhile, hopes major cities in the country would be able to vaccinate half of their target population this year. The country has fully vaccinated 30% of its target 77 million Filipinos, which is 70% of the total Philippine population.
We are confident that most, if not all, major cities in the country will be hit and even surpass this target before Christmas. Sana.
Meantime, an advisory group to the World Health Organization recommends an additional COVID shot for immunocompromised individuals. The Strategic Advisory Group of Experts on Immunization adds a third dose should be offered to senior citizens vaccinated with Sinovac and Sinopharm's COVID jabs. NVOC Chair and Health Undersecretary Mirna Cabotaje says this will be raised to the country's all-experts group, who are scheduled to meet this week for their recommendation. But for the Philippine Food and Drug Administration, it sees no need for COVID-19 booster shots for now. FDA Director General Eric Domingo says his agency has found no waning effects in the shots administered in the country. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.